Hi friends. In my coaching training, I learned about the principle of okayness, which was developed by Milton Erickson in his therapy practice. He developed an approach called solutions-focused therapy. And one of the principles that he had adhered to is this principle of okayness, which meant that people aren't broken, fundamentally broken, that there's nothing that needs fixing, and that people are okay as they are. And this process is used in coaching, this kind of concept is used in coaching as well. And I found it to be also very powerful in daily life. It's something that is kind of difficult to fully integrate. I think it's can be difficult to really truly live it, but it gets easier over time. And I think it's related to a principle that is maybe taught in Buddhism, which is that you should love everyone. And this is also something that I think is really, really difficult. And I remember many years ago when I first came across this, I think I read somewhere that better to pity someone than to hate someone, but best of all to love them. And that should be the ultimate goal, for us to love everyone. But in the absence of love, pity at least is better than hate. I used to take that literally, and I would try my best to this people that I would despise, that I would pity them instead, which is relatively easy compared to loving them. To pity someone who is might be considered evil, that's easy, because when you notice that people who do terrible things are doing as much damage to themselves as they do to other people, you know, the psychological torment that they go through their evil acts, is truly pitiable, and you know, it's better, you know, it's easier also to deal with it if we pity someone than if we are angry. Anger tends to cloud judgment, although it's also okay to be angry at times when necessary, and when it comes, when we truly feel it. But the next step now is to move towards love. Can we love people that we find detestable in some ways? And there's a practice of meditation that I learned about 8 years ago when I was traveling through Spain. I found a book on meditation, which is, I think, just called Meditation, The Buddhist Way to Tranquility and Insight by Kalama Shila, a British Buddhist monk. And he goes through different types of meditation, mindful breathing meditation, and another one, which I don't remember what he calls, but it's kind of like Vipassana. And then the final one is a meditation on love, loving kindness meditation. And through the meditation, you begin by focusing your love on the people that you already love, that are really important to you, the people around you that you love. And then you extend that circle of love to all of your friends and all of your acquaintances, and you make it wider, and to everyone around you, everyone that you know, and then even including people that you don't like so much, and then people that you despise, and people that you find truly despicable. And the idea is to really, as you're meditating, as you're kind of imagining, visualizing this kind of love spreading out from you, to give it to everyone, including the people that you might otherwise really, really hate or pity. That's a process that I think can be very powerful. Perhaps you've heard the parable from, I guess it's a Buddhist parable. It goes like this. A mother, she loved her son very much, and he wanted him to be happy for the rest of his life. So she took him to a monk, and she said, "Monk, I want my son to be happy. Could you make everyone love my son?" And this monk had magic powers, and he granted her a wish, and everyone would love her son. So she walked out of the temple, and outside people started greeting her son and giving him good wishes and giving him gifts and presents and hugs and kisses. And at first, the son was so glad, so happy to be receiving all of this attention. But slowly, as more and more people gathered and a crowd started to form, he began to be a little bit overwhelmed by the attention. And eventually he started pushing people away to give himself some space. And the mother could see that she'd made a mistake. Her son wasn't happy anymore. Now he was upset and frustrated, and so she ran back to the monk and asked him to undo this spell. And he said, "I will undo the spell, but only under one condition. You must tell me what you should have wished for to give your son true happiness." And so the mother, she sat in the temple for 3 days and three nights, thinking hard, and eventually she came up on the answer, and she went to the monk and she said, "I should have wished that my son love everyone, because when we, that's the end of the story, but when we love everyone around, we of course we're going to be happy." Think about that for just one moment. What is more likely to bring you happiness? People loving you or you loving people? People loving you is completely unnecessary. If you love everyone, regardless of how they feel about you, you can guarantee a life of happiness. And that is a choice that you have within yourself. It's a practice that you can practice within yourself. So I've just been thinking about that, related to this principle of okayness from coaching. People are okay as they are. Nobody's broken and there's nothing to be fixed. People have the resources within themselves to become their own true best self. And I really believe that there's such a huge amount of potential inside every one of us. We have this incredibly complex mind, the most complex thing in the universe that we know of. And we it's so untapped, so much in there that we just don't use. So if we could truly connect with what our own power is, we will have a massive impact on the world and on ourselves. So that's it for today. I'll see you tomorrow.